I think that the light bulb is working because of the tungsten filament.
A paperclip can light up electricity because it's made of metal and metal is a conductor of electricity.
Wait, guys, look.
See, he's got a segmental body and he has no legs.
Once the students have developed an explanation of a new concept, it is important to involve the students in further experiences where they are able to apply or extend the new concept and skills in a new context.
The elaborate phase is really important for the students because it provides them with an opportunity to be able to refine their ideas, refine their thinking, to challenge their thinking.
I think that the earwig belongs to the annelids.
I agree with her, actually.
I disagree. Because I think it kind of has a hard body.
So it could be an arachnid, which I don't think it is, or an insect or a myriapod.
I think it only has one set of antennae. So I think it will be an insect because it's also got six legs.
Okay.
In the elaborate phase, teachers support students in the use of science inquiry skills such as questioning and predicting, planning and conducting, processing and analysing information, evaluating and communicating.
So for the slaters, we found 17 of them. We put it in tallies. So 5, 5, 5, 15 and 2 more is 17.
So I found a centipede.
And lots of worms.
Some arachnids.
When the students are working collaboratively in their small groups, it really is a hive of thinking, discussing, reviewing their thinking together. So it's a very harmonious classroom where everyone wants to be part of their learning.
Working in their collaborative teams, each team member has a role and all are active participants in the investigation process.
We should get some flowers and maybe...
Flowers?
Yeah, and the rock maybe. For...
Can you maybe look under there with...
There are different types of investigations in the elaborate phase. For example, survey, design, secondary data investigations, and fair tests.
It's great as a teacher being able to see students conduct a fair test. If they see another group doing something wrong, they'll say, hey, you know, why are you changing that? That's not allowed to be changed. They like seeing it done properly.
The variables are the size of the blades, which we're going to change. We're measuring the speed that the weight is lifted and we're keeping the same the shape of the blades.
A key component of the elaborate phase is the collecting of data. Young students collect data but often ignore it unless they are given the opportunity to analyse the data and draw conclusions.
Research has shown that students will typically discount the data that they've collected, so they will often revert to their previous non-scientific ideas unless they go through this form of discussion afterwards.
Well, we decided to express our findings in a table.
Through our findings, we found that anything that has metal on it was a conductor.
It's really important for students to have the opportunity to discourse with one another. There's often more than one explanation for why they've got the results that they've got. So for students to engage with one another, offer ideas, offer suggestions, talk about different ways of interpreting that data is a very important part of scientific investigating and scientific process.
Yes, our team got almost all the same results, except I disagree that the peg is a conductor, because when we connected at the wires with the peg, it was an insulator.
That's true, except we decided to use the metal thing that holds the peg together.
By discussing the quality of their evidence, students make meaning of their experiences and develop deeper conceptual understandings.
Has anyone got any questions they can ask this group? Try and use the question starters on the board to help you if you're not.
I find the question starters extremely useful for the discussion after the investigation. I think it supports the students in developing a question which challenges the students who are presenting.
What caused the flat blades to work better?
Because the flat blade was a lot easier to pick up wind.
I agree with what you guys said because my group did something similar.
Do you think it would affect your investigation
if you had a third reading on the...
When I see the children having in-depth discussions, it's so exciting because you just think, whoa, here they are, they're justifying their reasons, because that's what we have to do in our lives. We have to verbalise what we've got. We have to gain the knowledge, internalise it, and then we have to verbalise what we think and justify it.
Through the investigation process and discussions, the teacher is provided with opportunities for summative assessment of the student's investigation skills. The completion of the investigation then leads to the fifth phase of the 5 E's, evaluate. The purpose of the elaborate phase is to enable students to apply concepts and explanations in new contexts, provide opportunities to extend student skills and understanding, assist students to make generalizations, and provide an opportunity for summative assessment of inquiry skills.